There's nothing like an action-packed war movie on Thanksgiving. Let's talk about it. What is up, Netflix fans? Welcome back to my channel. The brand new movie Mosul just dropped on Netflix today. We're going to talk about it. Thank you to Netflix for providing me this screener, and let's get into it. So when ISIS took their homes, family, and city, one group of men fought to take it back. And of course, guys, if you like this review and you're a fan of the war genre, leave this vid a thumbs up. And I was very excited for this movie, not only because it was directed by Matthew Michael Carnahan, his first directing gig. He's been an extremely consistent writer for years in Hollywood, and obviously his brother Joe Carnahan is an extremely famous and talented name. Then you have the Russo brothers, Anthony and Joe, producing this movie. And I like the fact that we are focusing on maybe something that we don't often focus on, and that is a group of soldiers that aren't from America or are not assisted by America. And you guys know me, I love a good war film. Doesn't matter what kind of movie it is, if it's World War I, World War II, modern day, I'm just a huge fan of the genre. And the fact that this is A, based on a true story, and B, starring some extremely talented individuals, this movie really caught my attention, more so from the premise and less so from the first 15 minutes of the movie. Because I won't lie to you, I was finding some issues with the pacing. I was finding some issues with the fact that the film did not feel like it knew what it wanted to be at first. And I was unsure what the mission of these individuals was as we were progressing, because they didn't make it very clear to us what their goal was. Now, along the way, they do encounter something that becomes their mission, and I like the fact that they make that priority above all else, and I found that to be extremely interesting. But the first few scenes of the movie, I'm sitting here thinking, okay, what is the goal here? But then you settle down, you realize what this film is, the action-packed nature of it. I swear to you, I felt like I was watching Call of Duty at times. It's filmed extremely well. I think there were issues with the direction as a whole, and I would have maybe done a few things differently, but you can't blame someone like Matthew Carnahan, who is directing his first ever feature film. I was actually really happy with the result here. I thought Mosul was extremely interesting, very action-packed, thrilling, engaging from beginning to end. Once it found its footing and I started to realize, okay, what this story actually is, that's when I got on board. That's when I started to like these characters a bit more. And that's when I really started to enjoy myself. I've seen a bit of divisiveness from a few critics here and there, but in terms of what you're looking for in a war movie like this, if you're seeking out action, if you're seeking out leadership, and you have those characters in this movie, Major Jasem specifically, who is kind of the leader of this band of brothers in arms, and just relentless, grueling as the film itself is, and determined to lead this team to victory. And that's what I love seeing in a movie like this. The character of Jasem was great. The character of Kawa, he starts out as this cop. He seems very inexperienced. He doesn't necessarily know what he's doing at first, it seems. And then he's rescued by this elite SWAT team. He's introduced to this squadron of brothers. And at first, it feels like he's an outcast. They slowly start to accept him for who he is. But there's always going to be that tension, because we don't know if you're a spy. We don't know if you're just infiltrating us to learn about what we're doing, and that just adds another element to this story, the unsure nature of these characters about each other. Well, we do have this brotherhood, but there's this one guy. Can we trust him? And from his perspective, do I belong here? And the unit is on this extremely dangerous operation. The goal is to wipe out an enemy base and restore this decimated city, what they refer to as this lawless territory. And the opening shot of the film, we kind of pan over and see all of the damage and destruction, and we understand what they're fighting for right off the bat. I love the fact that they established that. I love the visuals in this movie. I would have made some different decisions when it comes to the camera movements, but again, it's such a difficult thing to capture because there's so much going on within this film, so much action, which I thought was executed extremely well, extremely entertaining. We have to liberate this city. We have a fearless leader. We are a fearless group of individuals. We have one guy who is a bit unsure at first, but he literally has one of the better character arcs from any character in a war movie that I've seen all year. He goes from unsure, inexperienced, to what he is by the end of the film, and as soon as he dons a specific piece of clothing, you're like, oh man, this is an awesome character arc, and I was really here for it, and it just added so much more to a movie like this. Now, there were some other things about the movie. Of course, I did this via subtitles. I didn't even look if the film had the dubbing option, but there were times when there would be dialogue happening, but they would not show the subtitles. So from that perspective, it's almost like, okay, well, this is not important, so we're not going to show you subtitles. But I like to know everything that all of the individuals were saying, so unless you speak that language, you didn't really know what was happening, so that kind of frustrated me. Also, because there are so many individuals in this group, there are times where characters die, and I wanted to know more about those characters. I wanted to feel the impact, and you definitely feel it, but I feel as if we would have had time to build up at least a few of them, not just our main two or three characters. That would have helped with the emotional connection between that character and I, so there are definite nitpicks and issues that I have with this story. It could have progressed a bit better. It could have played out a bit easier. And I do think at times they were kind of overcomplicating things. But at the end of the day, if you're just looking for entertainment, if you're looking for an emotional war story that's based on a true story, I think that's what you're going to get from this movie. And I like the fact that the Russo brothers produced this. I am going a 68% with my score. Thank you guys so much for watching this video. I need you in the comments down below. Were you excited for this film? And let me know if you are watching this on Netflix today. It is out. Appreciate you guys for watching. Stay tuned. Another review coming for the brand new Melissa McCarthy film, Super Intelligence. So you want to stay for that one? Okay, bye.